Hit record. All right, today is November 28th, 2023. It's 4:05 p.m. Eastern. Diego Silva is on the call. Hi, Diego.
Hello.
Hey, so I got confirmation from your dad in writing the email that it's okay for us. Right. Let me see if I can share my screen. There you go. Good. Here we go. You can see my screen, Neo?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So first of all, thank you for taking your time, and thank you for doing the prep work, because you know I already sent you some questions previously and you sent me your answers, so I added your answers to this slideshow anyway. So first things first, check-in questions, obviously. How are you?
I'm pretty good.
Are you still happy with the team, still happy with the coach?
Yeah.
Are you happy with your position?
Yeah, I'm happy with it.
Yeah. So your position, you're number eight, but your best and favorite is also central mid. So my instructor knows. Are you paying attention to nutrition? And do you have a healthy sleep pattern? I made you think about that and actually put it in writing, because that was one of the questions I sent, right? That's one of the off-field.
Yeah, my dad has been helping a lot. He makes me dinner every night, so yeah.
A lot of variety in your dinners, or what time do you get home from school?
I get home from school at like three, around three. Yeah.
What time do you eat for our 7:30 session?
Oh, I usually eat right when I get home, like 3:30 maybe, 3:15.
And you're not hungry before session anymore? You're good to go?
Sometimes I eat like a little bar. I'm not really that hungry.
Yeah, protein. All right. How are things at school?
Pretty good. Going good.
Yeah. Your SATs are coming up, right?
Yeah, I think so, in like a month or two.
Yeah. So we talked about the off-field aspects already, about the nutritional value. You know, if you want to approach things in the right way, nutrition is actually a very important part of it. You know, mental health, well-being, and a healthy diet. So I sent you these questions before. Your answers are right here in green. So I made you think about who or what your social support people or things are. Was that a good exercise for you? Have you ever thought about that in the past, or was this the first time?
No, I haven't really thought about it that much.
So what did you come up with?
I read the questions and I thought who connects with me and stuff. So that's how I answered them.
I saw that your dad, you know, was mentioned a lot there. So that mean your mom is not that involved, or is your dad just really like a diehard fan kind of thing?
Well, my mom doesn't really like the sport that much, but she's supportive, but she doesn't really help me that much with the sport.
Is it just your dad, or do you have other people that support you off the field?
It's just really my dad. I don't really talk to anybody about soccer outside, like in school.
You don't have your diet, you mentioned your dad there. You don't have private coaches or like newsletters or like motivational speakers perhaps that you follow online or something like that?
No, not really.
Just you yourself and your dad?
Yeah.
All right. Well, it seems to work for you, because you're doing very well on and off the field. So I'm happy for that. I noticed that, and you actually mentioned this in one of your answers as well, that you don't really feel nervous before a game. And I do get that feeling from you too, that you just show up and it's, I'm not going to say it's just a game, but you feel very comfortable when you're on the field. Is there anything specific that you do in order to feel that way? Or you think about that when you were answering these types of questions?
I don't really think about whether we're going to win or lose. I just think about if I'm going to do good or bad, really. But I don't get nervous or anything.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know. I'm not scared to play or anything.
You're confident in yourself?
Yeah.
Is there anything that you do specifically before a game, like during the week or just day of the game, in order to feel that confident or prepare yourself?
Not really. I guess eat some good food before the game, like an hour or two before, so I don't get like a stomach ache. Heavy stomach during the game.
And you watch a lot of games. I remember that. You know, big Heat fan, so I guess you watch a lot of games too. So you probably have that cognitive like load and that visualization of certain patterns already in your head that you probably feel comfortable and confident on what to do in certain game situations.
Yeah. Usually I either watch a game that's on before we play, or I play a little FIFA before we play just to get ready for sport.
Do our sessions in the week help you?
Yeah.
Why do you think that is?
They just like keep me up to speed, you know? So my touches are good, my passing's still good for the games. You know, so I don't get out of form.
Right. Do you think our sessions are game specific?
Yeah, we do a lot of we run through the specific steps during a game.
All right, good to hear. I'm happy to hear that. You know, it's what we call a perception-based learning and training session. So I try to give you guys, you know, tactical game situations as well. You know, trying to ask those figure questions, you know, and cues, you know, what do you see? What can we do better in order to see more of the field, like the scanning, in order to make your decision-making a little bit better. So action execution is very important. But in order for us to get there, I have to paint a picture in you guys' head and actually show you guys what could possibly happen in a game so we can actually repeat it, repetitions. You know, we do the same tactical situation a lot, you know, profession, the topic-based kind of thing. And I understand that it might be a little repetitive / boring. It might be a better word, you know, for some, especially in the younger age groups, but the repetitions are key. So, you know, the concentration, the focus and the discipline is very important. So I just want to point that out, that you also came a long way. So I've been coaching you for a couple of years now. And in the beginning, I remember you had some difficulties trying to stay focused throughout the session. But now that you see the value of what and how we're doing it, you know, you've come a long way. So just wanted to point that out. Other areas of improvement for training sessions. Obviously, you know, in the beginning, we determined that, you know, conditioning, stamina-wise, and the high-intensity runs were actually a working point for you. I know that you've been doing them before or after practice. Do you feel that you're getting better?
Yeah, we did I think it was last week. We did like a mock game last week, and I ran much more than I used to, like prior to that, in the mock games.
Yeah. Does that help you, you know, well, be confident and have that positive mindset in games as well, for as a preparation kind of thing, because you feel that you're getting better and you know that you're getting better?
Yeah, because before I was, I don't know, I'd get the ball and I just feel tired. So I just pass it as quick as possible most of the time.
Yeah. So it's not necessarily a bad thing, right? Let the ball do the work. So that comes down to decision making kind of thing. Let me go down here to the game. So just some context from my educator at US Soccer. So we both watched a game probably more than once between both of us. At home versus Key Biscayne, which was number 9 in Florida. It was a home win 2-1 for us. So we went over the game. The video link is right here. We determined some data sets. Obviously, did it together with Diego, so we couldn't really go into very detailed or very complex data sets. So we kept it very generic, because I do think that it would have been a good exercise for Diego as well, and not just for me. So we focused on successful possession, successful passes. Obviously, the unsuccessful counterpart of that, the dribbles, possession won, and possession lost. And we have some percentages next to it. So there's always room for improvement. So we took one data set out of this, and we focused on the lost possessions. So basically these 7 instances. So we had 21 possessions, and we lost the ball 7 times. So basically a third, 33.3%. So we started looking at those lost possessions. I'll start the video in just a minute. But this is just a visual on the location where we lost the ball. Obviously, the little thingies here are dribbles where we lost the ball. And then a longer ball between thirds and between channels. And this was actually a penetrating dribble. There was not much you could do here because there were 2 people on you. So we're kind of focusing on these here in the defending mid third and attacking middle third. So again, 7 instances out of 21 lost. We're just going to take a look at them right now, and let's see if we can find a pattern. That was you. That's the left foot long ball. That's not the same one. That's actually the same left foot long ball. The dribble, defending mid third, where we lost possession. And here, technical touch. This is the one with penetrating dribble here with 2-3 people on you. Couldn't really do much on that one. So the dribbles that we see here, obviously technical mistakes. This one going back, not light on your feet. And this one, the recovery ball right here. So this one is the first one where you lose it, where you're not light on your feet. Right, let me just go here. See, you control, ball gets stuck under your body kind of thing. You lose the ball. You get up and then pay attention to which foot and which surface of the foot you're going to use in order to control it. And then you can tell me what you could have done better on that play. See that? What surface of the foot did you use on that one to control it?
I can't see very clearly, but I imagine it was like my outside right or something. Yeah. I shouldn't.
Right, outside right. So if you can control that ball with the inside left, you have a higher percentage of actually keeping in play. There was one more here. Yep. Like first touch, ball goes up a little bit higher than it's supposed to go. You have to correct it. Obviously, the kid physically stronger than you just gets you off the ball. So this is a good thing, because this was also part of our initial plan, individual play development plan in the beginning, where this was actually a coaching or a working point for you and for us to improve your left foot. So this is basically what we had come up with in the beginning. Improve your 1v1s attacking third, central. So obviously we had those, we only had one instance in this one. I didn't really pick those out for this meeting. Improve first touch directional away from pressure. Those were a couple of instances in that video with your left foot directional away from pressure. So, you know, this is relevant to that. Improve receiving on a half turn with the left foot. That's actually very relevant in this instance. So we're gonna keep working. I mean, we still have the activity, right, from the beginning. So I know that you've been doing them because we met, you know, just a brief check-in a couple of weeks ago, I think, or like a month ago, month and a half ago. And I remember us doing this too in the beginning where, you know, we kind of did the activities together, set up so you can actually start doing them on your own time. And you don't really need me to be there for you as a private coach. But obviously the left foot is something that we still have to work on because 7 out of 21 there are all left footed in place. So we're going to keep doing it. We are towards the end of the season, you know, we'll have that player maker tracker as well. So we can actually see the data where it's no longer just a feeling from you saying, hey, I feel like I'm getting better. I feel like I'm running more because we'll have data to go back on. And then we can actually put them side by side and show you factually that you are getting. And, you know, the reason why we do this, because, you know, so that's basically the action plan going forward. We keep putting in the extra work before, after practice, 3 days, you know, the highlight videos as well. You know, the player maker stats with the tracker, you know, will come in as well. So we'll see that happen. The next time we're going to meet is probably going to be March for this A license course. But obviously we see each other 3-4 times a week anyway. So, you know, there'll be other times when you and I can have like a brief check-in kind of thing. If you have any questions moving forward. And I encourage you to keep doing your own research as well, because, you know, now that obviously you've taken a lot of steps. So in the beginning, you were looking for just generic conditioning, stamina activities, right, to raise that bar in your baseline. But now that you have that certain baseline, now we can actually move into more of like quick player, high intensity, repetition and a sprint, change of direction, high intensity sprint, basically cut back your recovery time needed versus, you know, 2-3 months ago. So and keep doing that. But I encourage you to keep doing your own research as well. And I know that you've done it because you asked me about certain articles and videos as well. So I just want to point that out, that you're on the right track and you're doing it. That's kind of it for me at this point. I mean, I am going to see you tonight, so if you have any questions, feel free. But do you have any questions that you can think of or might of right now?
No, I don't have any questions. I'm good.
Good. Yeah. All right. I'm going to stop the recording. Stop recording. All right. Thank you, Diego. See you later.
Bye. See ya.